Honestly, for coming to Thailand to have my surgery done, number one, Thailand has beautiful lady boys everywhere. And if they can make a man look like a beautiful woman, they're going to make a woman look absolutely beautiful. So I had a lot of faith in the surgery over here because they do it a lot. It's the surgery is done all of the time. And the price compared to Australia, and being able to stay in hospital for 8 nights while I had my surgery to recuperate, would not have had that at home. So it was by far the best decision I could have made, yeah. My name's Michelle, I'm from Brisbane in Australia, and we have been over in Thailand now for 3 weeks and had some surgical procedures done. No, my second time. I did also come last year for breast augmentation and a nipple lift. And this year I have come over and had a breast lift, an extended tummy tuck and a thigh lift. So I have been a single mum for 15 years. I have 3 children who are all older now, and having lost 50 kilos, it was the first time I could put myself first and actually do something to make myself look and feel younger. And as a nursing student, which I am now too, I had researched a lot into the procedure and everything has gone fantastic. I got my body ready for the surgery, and now that it's been done, the healing was fantastic. So yeah, it was the first time I was able to put myself first. For me, I have been on a weight loss journey for the last 18 months. I have lost 50 kilos, and through having had gastric sleeve surgery and lots of exercise, losing all of that loose skin, and now having the surgery and all of that loose skin being gone is amazing. I feel fantastic. I feel in proportion. The surgery has gone very well, and my skin feels amazing. So it's been great. Yeah, all of the staff that we have had here, from everybody who helps you at the hotel, all of the nurses and the surgeons, the destination beauty team and the driver, very safe and secure, and it has been a wonderful experience, yeah. I now feel younger. I can do more things than I was ever able to do. So yeah, back to playing sport, back to feeling less tired, fitter, lots better than what I was, yeah. I had done a lot of research last year, a lot of reviews from people that had talked about it, and a lot of emails. I think your correspondent that you deal with when you're setting up to have your appointment answer all of the questions that you want to know. They send you photos, they reassure you. So having that really good connection with your correspondent that you book your procedure through, and also meeting the surgeon in Australia, made me feel reassured to be able to have it done. So
you went to see?
Yes, in Brisbane, yes. And I actually got to meet Dr. Kasemsak, who was my surgeon, and he was fantastic. So even though he had seen my photos through my emails, he got to see me in person, and I then felt very reassured about having the surgery done. In the hospital?
Yeah.
So Dr. Kasemsak, he is a very relaxed surgeon, and he is very easy to communicate with. He actually makes you feel very, very secure. He offers advice, like even with my breast augmentation, he said to me, without even giving me size or anything like that, just put different ones in so you could see what looked the best. He's very knowledgeable in what he does. And my scar lines are very low and very straight and very neat, and are already, only 3 weeks later, they're nearly all healed up and looking fantastic. So thank you very much, Dr. Kasemsak. You have 100% changed my life, and it is the first time in over 20 years that I feel very feminine and very beautiful. Great. I actually was expecting there to be a lot of pain, and I wasn't. I actually woke up, I had spoken to my anaesthetist first and said I did not want to wake up feeling sick. And I said I was scared that I was going to be, but because you have pain medication with the drip, because I had a lot of surgery procedures done, I didn't have any pain at all. So it was actually very good, yes. No, I brought my mother. Last time when I came for surgery just with breast augmentation, I came with a friend. But this time, because it was a big surgery and I knew it was going to be a little bit difficult, my mum came with me. And honestly, you couldn't do it alone. You need to bring somebody with you because you need somebody to help you when you're needing for showers and for getting food and for things like that. And if you have days where you're feeling a little bit emotional, that support person makes all of the difference in your recovery. But the good thing as well, if you can't have a support person, staying at the hotel where you can see people at breakfast time and talk to them, and you can go for afternoon tea and talk to them, and you talk to people in the surgery consultation, that is very supportive too. So you build a network of people that you're all very supportive together. Yeah. I can 100% say, especially for women that are sitting at home, and we always put ourselves second. We put ourselves second as a wife, we put ourselves second as a mother. Take the time to do something for yourself and to make yourself feel beautiful. You only have one life. Do it while you are young and you get to have the opportunity to feel good in yourself for a long time. It's well worth it.